Hi everyone, in this video, I'll be talking about the real life account of someone that has launched a career buying and selling Birkin bags through the internet. Now, this is a story I came across recently. The story is in the form of a book called Bringing Home The Birkin, written by Michael Tonello, about his true account of his life of how he bought and sell Birkin bags through the internet. Now you might be asking, how did he actually launch his career? So he launched his career basically was he was formerly a makeup artist and also hairstylist, and he was traveling internationally for work. So he received a job offer from someone saying that, you know, there's a job assignment over in Spain and maybe he should migrate to this particular country. So he packed up all his things, then he moved over to Barcelona in Spain. And then unfortunately, when he moved to the country, he realized that the job offer had just crashed, had just fallen apart. So now he was stuck in a foreign country with a 5-year lease on an apartment with no job offer, no work visa, significant language barrier, and now not much financial ways to stay afloat. So he began to panic. And then he came up with this great idea, you know. There are things in his house that, you know, there are certain things that he felt that he could sell it on eBay to keep himself financially afloat until the thought of what to do next. So he began selling items in his house, and one of the first items he sold was a Ralph Lauren cashmere scarf. Now, based on that, he thought that, you know, hey, if this item is branded, maybe it'll fetch a good price on eBay, and maybe I can use the money to just keep myself financially afloat until I figure out my next action. So he sold the scarf, and then he realized that, hey, there are people who actually want certain items. So anything that was in his apartment that he felt like would actually end up being bought by people on eBay, he actually started selling it. So he sold a bunch of things, and then he realized that he picked up certain tactics on how to actually sell things on eBay. For example, whenever he sold items, he would take like a 7 to 10 day sort of auction. So this 7 to 10 day auction means that if you sell item on day one, by day seven, you can, you know, the auction ends, and that sort of creates an urgency for people to buy things from you. And you specifically time the auction to end on a Sunday evening. Now, his general principle was that if it's Sunday evening, most probably people are at home and people have time to go online shopping and people have time to sort of see through his listing. So it's pretty successful doing this business. And then there's one item that he sold that sort of launched his career into selling and buying Birkin bags online. And that item was a Hermes scarf. Now, he realized that when he launched this particular item that he had, sold it online, there were a lot of like interest and people started like bidding on it. And then when the auction ended, someone bought the scarf. There were a lot of people actually started messaging him saying that, you know, hey, I noticed you sell this Hermes scarf. Do you have other Hermes scarves? And then he began to notice something very interesting. If you could get a product for X price and you could sell it for like double the price or triple the price on online, it would make sense for him to actually pursue this as a business. And he started to realize that there are very, very serious buyers on eBay at the time. They were very interested in Hermes scarves. So he then started to move on into this niche business of buying and selling Hermes scarves. So he would buy and sell Hermes scarves, and he started creating a wish list for his customers, saying that, okay, you know, since you like these things, tell me what you want. I'll go and find it for you, and I will list it online, and then you can go and buy it. One of his loyal customers actually been buying a lot of things from him, started saying that, she joked around and said that, you know, haha, I would like it if you can get me a Birkin bag. And at the time, he wasn't sure what a Birkin bag was. And in actual fact, Birkin bag is one of the most rare and most expensive handbag in the world. And legend has it that there is a waiting list to even buy the handbag, like a 2 to 3 year waiting list. And not only that, there's also a legend that says that there is a waiting list to get on the waiting list to get the handbag. And it's so rare that everybody that has the means to afford it really, really, really wants to get this handbag. So he got really very curious, you know, like he was thinking like, okay, if a Birkin bag is pretty expensive, like say a 20,000 to up above, it could be also $250,000. So why not I try to crack this, you know, case? To him, the product was just a product that he realized that if anybody was willing to pay for this bag, why not why not just respond to the demand of the customers? So he basically, you know, he started, you know, he had this mission and he wanted to like think like, can I ever get this Birkin handbag? So he went to his usual store where he bought this Hermes scarves and just asked the person at sales rep, and the sales rep was like, no, we don't have Hermes bag, it's not available, you can't get it. And there's a waiting list. And he was like, wait a second, I don't believe that it should be that difficult to get a Birkin bag. Then out of the blue, when he was doing one of his like shopping trips to get his customer's scarves, Hermes scarves, he basically had a list of all these Hermes scarves his customers wanted. And then probably I think he bought like about 10 Hermes scarves, and each scarf was about at least $200, something like that. So after he passed this customer rep, this sales rep, his list of scarves for them to help him get, then he casually asked them, by the way, do you have a Hermes bag? Do you have a Birkin bag? And then for the first time, the sales rep actually said yes, you know, and then they brought out the Birkin bag. And then he was like, wait a second. Everybody has been telling me that this bag is so rare. You have to get into the waiting list to get it, but for some reason that I'm able to finally get my hands on a Birkin bag. And he successfully purchased the scarves and also the Birkin bag. And that was when he discovered the formula of how to get the Birkin bag. Now you see, in the past, whenever he asked for the Birkin bag, it was just like very randomly asking the sales rep. And he discovered that when you show like you're interested, you're an interested buyer, and you're probably buying a significant amount of product from the company, then the sales rep probably realized that you're a very serious buyer and you have the means, or you're very, very interested to get their products. So that's only when they bring out the Birkin bag to you. And it also taught him about something in marketing, which is scarcity. Now, the reason why I believe luxury brands are so expensive is it could be the incredible workmanship and the craftsmanship that goes into a product, but it's also because there's this like sort of brand persona around the product. The more expensive, the more scarce it is to get a product, the more people sort of fall in love with the idea of getting a product. So scarcity was what he felt was driving this incredible like sort of mystery and desire to actually own a Birkin bag. So he finally got this Birkin bag, and that was when he started his business. So he went along and he sort of compiled wish list of Birkin bags, and he traveled and he got this product, and he had sort of devised a mechanism, basically. He devised a way of how he would profile the salespeople that were selling him this product. Because he felt to him that anytime he go into the store, if he wants to make a successful purchase of a Birkin bag, there must be a formula, there must be a structure, there must be a methodology in how to get this Birkin bag successfully from the different type of like sales reps in the store. So he sort of formulated a winning formula for himself based on his profiling. So he profiled like 4 to 5 different sales rep in a store, and you say that, you know, certain sales rep are probably of a certain age, maybe have a certain product knowledge of the brand. The likelihood of how easy or difficult it is to get a Birkin bag from them. And he also modify his approach according to different sales rep. So in this story itself, you can see that when somebody wants something, it's not just about coming up with a set formula of how to get something and just throwing up against the wall and just hoping to see whether it works or not. It's very important for us whenever we want to get something from people, we have to understand who they are in the first place. What are the objections? What are the ways to deal with a particular person? Because every person is probably different. So, and then also another thing that he did was that, you know, he was very careful about his appearance. Now, he felt like if he wanted to buy a very expensive product, he should also look the part. So he sort of took care of his appearance. He designed a certain sort of uniform that he used to wear. So he would wear, at that time he was making good money, so he got a bit of more money to sort of spend on coming out with a good outfit. So he felt that whenever he wears a certain outfit, it sort of indicates already that he has the kind of spending capacity. And so the salesperson will be also quite willing, and they will think in their head that, hey, this is a serious buyer. He has the means to actually afford a handbag, a very expensive handbag, like the Birkin handbag. So that was how he also crafted his way to get this handbag. Now, this story also is quite interesting at the time when once he started to come up with the formula, then he started having, he sort of taught like a friend of his to also come up with the same thing as well. And then he was realizing there was something very interesting in the luxury industry. the luxury industry has always sort of thrived on this like mystery of the product being so exclusive, so rare, so scarce. And based on the amount of Birkin bags he was buying a ton of Birkin bags. So he realized that, hey, maybe sometimes when it comes to marketing, sometimes the sort of mystery about a product is somewhat that creates it and drives the demand. So he went along with his business, and along the way, he made tons of money. He had very interesting stories about the people that he used to sort of work with to get his handbags, and came to a point where, you know, he was probably at the tail end of this particular business as well. At the time, there was a time where he sort of received a notification from this particular salesperson from a particular store where he bought a lot of handbags from, and the person was notifying saying that, due to leather restrictions or lack of stock and things like that, we're not able to fulfill your orders. And this was the time where he knew that they probably may have found out that there's somebody that's going around buying a lot of these Birkin handbags and is selling to a lot of people for a pretty good profit. So that and he probably felt like that this brand was already trying to was already figuring out, like, you know, they needed to stop people like him. So that was how he sort of ended up like discontinuing his business. But I think the most interesting story I got from this entire experience was that most of the time when we think about starting a business, we tend to think like we have to be struck by lightning, we have to come up with this incredible idea to start a business. But most of the time, you know, if we can think about situations where we start a business just because we try and we discover along the line, maybe there's a better idea of a better product or what we should be selling to the customer. Or along the line, we listen to the customer, we listen to what they want. And, you know, when they tell us what they want, we try in the best of ways, how can we fulfill their request? And so that sort of makes it a very interesting story for me. And also, I think it's probably a very interesting story for those in the marketing industry as well. Because I think that, you know, when it comes to creating a product that people would just die and wait in line to buy, you know, what is it about that product itself that you can create that is so highly wanted by customers? And it's not just because the product is well made or the product has great craftsmanship. It's also about the exclusivity, the incredible sort of sense of belonging. Like, if you have a product, you have entered a different club of the people that own that product as well. So this is a story I found very interesting, and I really encourage you to get the book, because I do know that you will enjoy the story as much as I have.